Hey, I'm Tashaka Armstrong, and welcome to the next episode of Tech for the Rest of Us. Today, we're going to be talking about Bluetooth wireless headphones. Now, the box for these, the Fireton MS Cord 530s, is pretty large, so you're probably expecting some pretty plush packaging when you crack it open, and that's exactly what you get. After you pull a rip tab that comes off the side of the box and actually lift up the flap here, you're greeted by another flap. It's like flap inception. It's actually a pocket that holds, let's see if I can get this out here, that holds everything but the headphones. Let's get this open. Alrighty. Put that over there, I know it's a lot. So this holds everything but the headphones. In the pocket, you actually get a bunch of stuff. You get the bag, you get the manuals, of course your warranty manual. You're gonna get a little travel plug that you can use on airplanes. You're going to get the mic cable, which comes with a single microphone, as well as volume controls and a few other items. Oh, you also get the charger. Now, when you lift the flap, let's get back to the main component that you're all tuned in to see. When you lift the flap, you actually are greeted by the very modern looking Cord 530s. They actually look like they should be in a Ferrari accessories catalog with their black and red styling, the silver arms. That's to say that they look industrial, modern, and very high end with a design aesthetic that says, we've taken great care to craft a fetching product, and we've given as much thought to performance as well. That was my bad Sean Connery, James Bond voice, I'm sorry. And they have, and we'll actually get to that in a bit. Let's get that out here. I'm gonna close that up. Now, the Fireton MS Cord 530s are class all the way. They look great, and the attention to detail is actually top notch. From the raised Fireton branding on the silver arms to the red stripe inlay in the headband, which actually bleeds over into flat, heavy-duty cabling that goes into the actual cans, to the black perforated, and I know this is hard to see, let's see if we can get that on camera, to the black perforated ear pads with red cloth peeking through the holes. These headphones are steady and good aesthetics. Now, sandwiched between the black backs of the cans and the black ear pads are chrome strips which house all the controls and connection ports. On the left, you have the wired headphone port, which is actually down here. It's covered, which actually keeps dust and debris out. Also on the left, you have the noise cancellation button, the slide toggle. On the right side is where you'll find the majority of the controls. Here you have the call button, microphone, a play, pause, skip, fast forward, rewind, volume rocker. Yes, this one thing here actually does it all. And then a covered USB charge port, a slot where the reset button is housed down here, it's hard to see, and the actual power button. The call button works as it does on most standalone Bluetooth earpieces in that it can initiate or end calls, but it's also capable of initiating voice dialing on phones that support the feature, as well as redialing the last number called. These headphones also fold up. They're actually pretty stiff when you first get them, but they also fold up. See what I mean? They're pretty stiff. They actually fold up for travel, and the hinges are pretty beefy with, I don't know if you heard it, a pretty satisfying click. They're pretty stiff when you get them, so it may take a bit of force to get them to fold. Once you get them fully unfolded, there we go, you can actually then take them and try to get them fitted onto you. You'll notice that the cans slide up and down on the arms of the headband with a click at each stop. They're attached to the headband on a platform that not only slides, but it also swivels like it's on a ball joint, providing what should be the optimum angle for comfortable contact with your ears. Now, while many headphones in this price range opt for a tuned sound profile, which favors bass, the 530s produce a bright, flatter stereo image. They have great range and wonderful clarity and are pretty balanced, though at times the bottom actually can feel a little weak. Where these headphones really shine is in the clarity of their sound reproduction. You really pick up all the instrumentation, all of the nuances in a composition. In older recordings, you can actually hear recording artifacts like record scratch and room tone. In addition, the clarity really sets tracks up for a very pleasing soundstage that's expansive. For good quality headphones, I found that some make you feel like you're in an intimate environment, and others front row at the Hollywood Bowl, and these definitely feel very spacious in their reproduction of airy tracks. Mids and highs tend to be more pronounced than the bottom, though in some hip-hop and EDM tracks with a heavy bass mix, the cans handle the bottom with aplomb. If you're in the market, I'd have to say that the Chord 530s are for people who are gonna want something with a flatter EQ curve that they can then take and EQ customize to their liking. As is, these are ideal for those who tend to listen to classical and more acoustic music, symphonies, operas, yep, you're good to go. Also worth noting is that these headphones come with a mic cable to go wired if your battery runs out while on the go. The 530s sound just as good when wired as they do when connected via Bluetooth, which says a lot about the quality of the stream the wireless connection provides, unless you turn on noise canceling. I found actually that when I turned on noise canceling, the music got a little muddy with the feature activated, and given that they cover your ears anyway, I didn't find the need to further reduce any background interference with my music playing at a decent level. My only gripe with performance would be wear. Part of listening to music for me is the escape the experience provides, and wear fatigue takes me out of the moment. The discomfort minimizes the escape. At 290 grams, which is 10 ounces, the 510 MS Chord 530s are on the heavier end of the spectrum for headphones in this class, and actually this padding on the headband doesn't help much. It's kind of this softish, rubbery material instead of a foam type material, which ultimately may hold up longer, but it doesn't feel like it's doing wearers any favors where comfort's concerned. Unfortunately, after a couple hours of wear, I could feel the fatigue setting in both from this headband and from the ear pads. The perforated covers, as opposed to the cups of other headphones, didn't quite work for me. Long periods of wear produced the feeling that the pads were pushing in on my ears and became uncomfortable. This could be just me, the shape of my own ears, and your experience may vary, but I have a friend who actually produces EDM, and I had him take a run at them, and he experienced similar discomfort. He and I are both big guys and may have similar geometry when it comes to how these fit our heads, but I thought I'd add that for the sake of fairness. Take note also that I have a huge head, and standard hats don't generally fit my big head. Oh, so, you know, again, your mileage may vary. Great looks, impressive performance are the hallmarks of the Phaeton MS530, but it just didn't pass muster where comfort is concerned. I think you should definitely give these a try on for yourself, try on a pair, see if it works for you, if you have the opportunity before making a final decision, because again, they may fit your head better than mine. These are definitely a strong product in the $200 to $350 price range, and the sound quality, the feature set, and the looks are well worth the cost if you have it to spend. They are pretty impressive headphones at the end of the day. Thank you for joining us and checking us out and watching this. If it's helped you make a purchasing decision, helped you not make a purchasing decision, whatever the case may be, please like, subscribe, share the video, and we'll check you out next time on Tech for the Rest of Us.